Welcome to the spoken tutorial on email configuration for DSpace. In this tutorial, we will learn to configure an email for DSpace, prepare a shell script to rebuild DSpace, send a test email from DSpace. This tutorial is recorded using Ubuntu Linux OS 18.04, DSpace version 6.3, Gedit text editor and Firefox web browser. However, you may use any other text editor or browser of your choice. To practice this tutorial, you should have installed DSpace 6.3 and you should have a working internet connection. Prerequisites. You should have familiarity with basic Linux commands. If not, then go through the prerequisite Linux tutorials on this website. The commands used in this tutorial are available in the code files link on this tutorial page. Please download and extract the file before practicing. I have opened the code file in the Gedit text editor on my machine. And I will use the same file to copy-paste the commands during the demonstration. Shortcut to paste on the terminal is Shift, Control and V keys. In DSpace, we have to configure the email settings to send emails from DSpace. DSpace sends emails to the users for various activities such as email verification during registration, notification emails during item submission and review, getting DSpace users' feedback, and notification to community and collection subscribers. Let us begin. Open the terminal by pressing Ctrl, Alt and T keys simultaneously on the keyboard. Ensure that you have root permissions to run the commands. Here onwards, please remember to press the Enter key after typing each command. Now, we will log in as user DSpace. Type sudo space su space hyphen space DSpace. If prompted, then type the password of the admin user to log in. Type the command as shown to open DSpace configuration file. If prompted, type the root user password. DSpace.cfg file opens in the Gedit text editor. Scroll down and locate the email settings section. DSpace requires SMTP service to send and receive emails. SMTP services like Gmail, SendInBlue, SendGrid, PeppyPost, Amazon SES, or Mandrill can be used. Additionally, custom SMTP services can also be set up and used. In this demonstration, I will configure a Gmail SMTP mail server. So first, I'll set the value for mail.server as smtp.gmail.com. Next, we have to enter a valid Gmail ID for mail.server.username. I will use the admin's mail ID, which is dspace.u1@gmail.com. You can also use the same email ID which you gave as your admin mail ID. The value for mail.server.password has to be the password of dspace.u1@gmail.com. The typed password will be visible to everyone, so I have blurred it for this demonstration. We will use Gmail's SMTP port SSL 465 to connect to the SMTP server. So let us disable the default SMTP port, which is 25. To do so, type hash in front of the line mail.server.port. Now, give a valid email address for mail.from.address. This email ID will be considered as the from address for the recipients. Here, I will type the value as dspace.u1@gmail.com. Please type a valid email address for feedback.recipient. If a user submits any feedback in dspace, then those feedback will be sent to this email ID. Here also, I will type the value as dspace.u1@gmail.com. We have to give a valid email address for mail.admin. System notifications and administration emails will be sent to mail.admin address. I will type the value as dspace.u1@gmail.com here. Next, we will configure the SMTP port SSL465. Scroll down and locate the line #mail.extra-properties. Remove hash symbol at the beginning of mail.extra-properties. Also remove hash symbol at the beginning of the next two consecutive lines as shown. Save and close the file. Whenever we customize dspace, it is necessary to rebuild dspace. Rebuild process involves compilation of source code, installation of web app, deployment of dspace on Tomcat server. We will prepare a shell script to rebuild dspace and use it whenever required. Open a new file named rebuild-dspace in a text editor. Type the shell commands as shown in the text editor. We have used these commands in the earlier tutorial to build dspace. Save and close the file. Type the command as shown to provide executable permissions to rebuild-dspace. If prompted, enter the admin password to proceed further. Let us rebuild dspace by typing the following command. The rebuild process may take some time depending upon your internet speed. On successful completion, build successful message will appear on the screen. This means we have deployed dspace email configuration on Tomcat server. Next, we have to configure some settings in the Gmail account which we have used. To access Gmail through dspace, less secure apps in Gmail settings should be turned on. To do so, log in to the respective Gmail account which we have typed in the email settings of dspace. Then, in the address bar, type the URL as shown. Turn on the toggle button for allow less secure apps. We have done the required configurations. Now, let us send a test mail. To do so, go to the terminal, then type this command to send a test mail. Test mail will be sent to the mail ID which was set in mail.admin in dspace.cfg file. Let us cross-verify this. Switch to the browser where our mail account is logged in. Now check the inbox for new mail. Here is the dspace test mail. We have successfully configured the mail configuration and also sent a test mail in dspace. Once done, sign out from the Gmail account. This brings us to the end of this tutorial. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we learned to configure email for dspace, prepare a shell script to rebuild dspace, and send test mail from dspace. The video at the following link summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please download and watch it. The spoken tutorial project team conducts workshops and gives certificates. For more details, please write to us. Please post your timed queries in this forum. Spoken Tutorial Project is funded by MHRD, Government of India. DSpace Spoken Tutorial Series is funded by the National Virtual Library of India, Ministry of Culture, Government of India. This script and video for this tutorial was contributed by Pankaj Patil from IIT Bombay. This is Nancy Verkey signing off. Thank you for joining.